Hello everybody, Project Cardboard, and last time I made a video and I ended up deleting it, so now this new video, you haven't used too much. Basically, I sprayed it with some spray glue to seal in all the details in the back and in the bottom, here, like that. It's kind of glossy, it's like this nice, gloss, and that will protect it, seal everything in, and then we can start to work on the top. So I have it here, I'm going to let it sit for maybe half an hour, just let it dry completely, maybe a full hour, just dry completely, soak in, seal in, then we can start. Now I sprayed it, and as you can see, it's glossy, so that'll protect it, and now I can feel confident to just turn it on its side, so that I can just start working on this part now. Alright everybody, so the plan is for me to take all these, and with this hot glue gun that I'm warming up, it's not ready yet, but what I'll do is, I'll take a bigger piece, stack it, like that, and then, but this will make up a piece to glue on top of it for the superstructure. But before I do that, I'll glue paper, just white paper, like this, on top of it. So, then after that, we can start adding rectangles, or like lines, or some more detailing. But first, I'm just gonna make a whole bunch of things like this. Just a whole bunch of these, and we can move from there. So, I will start to, I'll just wait for this to heat up, and then we can do that. And this here, I wrapped it in paper so that we can put it on, because I didn't want any glue or residue from here to get on the nice details we have. So I wrapped it in plastic here after spraying it, like I did. So now I can just work on here. Let me cut this. What I'll do is I'll take a piece of this foam, glue it on the paper, turn it over, glue it over so it'll look nice and clean and smooth. And we're not going to use the scissors, we're going to use the precision knife so that we can get the nice clean looks. So, it's fairly simple, and I'm planning on keeping the top part of this, the top portion of the ship, fairly simple because I don't think it needs to be as complex as the bottom, but it should have its fair share of detailing. So I'll glue this on top, maybe stagger it a bit, and that'll be one portion. So I'll just make a whole bunch of these, and then we can start to stack them. So I'll just have this here, or maybe I can do a few at a time, like glue that, then glue the second one, and glue the third one, and so on. And I'll just cut them. That. And we want the top one to, we want it to be like a pyramid, so the bottom one is bigger than the top one. That's a little rough. It's fine. And if the piece itself, if the foam isn't big enough, it's just to give it structure, so you can make it overlap quite a bit. A good chunk of the way. So, I'm gonna make a whole bunch of these until I finish up all these foam pieces, and then we can start to detail them further. The main parts we need to put some more detailing in this flat part here is mainly on the edges, because that's basically what the only part that we're gonna be seeing. So, the first passive detail that I'll do is just cut little rectangles like that and then push it down into the foam so I can get some texture, just basically texturing the whole thing. We don't want to cut holes like the whole thing because then we'll have nothing to put on, but just like put that maybe, and with the scissor comes apart so you can like clean it and stuff, so with this part I'll just push it in like that just to show, I don't know, maybe some other stuff that's going on in there. Some more layers of the city or anything like that. Just push it in. And then some of these cutoffs that we have from making the superstructure. Connect these back. These are very nice scissors too. I will glue some of these cutoffs right along the edges there. When you're using an aluminum edge like this, sometimes
especially if you're cutting on it a lot, because this is meant for like drawing with, I think, but if you're using a knife on it, you'll get this staining. And aluminum stains paper somehow. Somehow it just gets this grayish color, so you have to be careful with that. But again, I don't really care about this getting a little bit messed up, because we're not going to see it very much. Maybe a little rectangle here. It's more of a line. Stop that whole thing. We don't want foam to be really showing. We want the whole thing to be looking like paper. And it is paper. As such. So, now, I'll switch my hot glue gun to hot H. Very good hot glue gun, BTW. So what I'll do is now, I ripped up this place more, cut some holes, some tunnels and stuff. Now we'll just have to glue these in. So, gonna put this in. Maybe I should actually test them first, because I don't want to fill in and then I won't be able to put stuff in. So first of all, I'll just do like I did before. I'll probably change the template a little bit than it was from earlier, but it'll be about the same. Gonna fill this, that maybe here. I'll put that there. Fine. That's fine. I'll cut this in half. Hope it'll cut smooth, please. Cut that like that. It's kind of hard cutting through foam and paper, but that's always good to find some sort of a pattern. In fact, what I should have done was I should have took a pencil and just outlined where everything should be and like numbered the part, but it's not too bad. So, put that there. There we have it! So now I'm going to glue stuff down. So I'll take this one. And I'll give you guys some close-ups after this to show you why I roughed up the bottom and stuff. Just so you can see how the detail really pops when you do that. Put that there. Keep everything straight as possible. Put that there. I don't want to mess up this. Put that there. I don't even know how accurate this is to the thing, because for the past few days of building this, I haven't been looking at the reference images, so I don't know if I'm doing this correctly or not, but it's fine. And every model of the executor class, I don't know if it's executor or executor, tell me in the comments. But I don't, like, everyone seems to have a different opinion of how it looks, so it's just kind of one of the more fun things. That's the whole reason why I chose to build this. Because it's just so fun, you can just do as you wish with it. Because there's no one way of doing it. Especially because the films didn't have any clear screenshots of scenes of it flying about the sky.
And here it is, all finished, glued in, secured inside. So if I get close, right now we have some light. So if you look inside, you can see some of that detailing that I did, and it just adds some more depth instead of just these blocks. And even there you can see it. There, towards the edge. I'm gonna put something to fill in here. But that is good. So now I'm going to cut some more tiny pieces of paper and glue them all on top of here. Very simple. Just like I did on the bottom there. So I'm going to just glue some there, and put a platform here so we can put the island or command center or whatever on top. So I put some more paper strips along on top of the parts of here, and now we can peel off some of this plastic and put some white paper along here to seal in this part. And then after that, what we're gonna have to do is apply detail to the edges all around it.